Hey guys, I am Jen and welcome to my channel where I help you become your best self through better health, through intentional and intuitive living and eating. All right, so today what I'm gonna be talking to you about are five simple ways that you can improve the health of your home, okay? So if that sounds good to you, let's get started. All right, guys, it's time to improve the health of your home. But before we get started, make sure you hit the subscribe button below and also the notification bell so that you will be notified for my next episode that will be dropping next Friday. So there'll be a new video every Friday. So make sure you hit that subscribe button so you don't miss out. Okay, so let's get into what I'm going to be talking about today. So basically, yeah, we've been spending a lot of time at home, right? And home has always been where the heart is. And I think now more so than anything, like people are finally realizing like, you know what? You know, since they're having to stay home more, that they're understanding the importance of their home. And I'm pretty sure that you have noticed some things and, you know, people have made home improvements and stuff like that. So I'm here to talk to you about how to improve the health of your home, which will help improve your health, okay? Because if you're not aware, your health is more than just what's on your plate, okay? And also more than just working out. So it includes your relationships, your career, it includes your level of fitness, it does, your level of well-being, physical well-being, and it also includes your hobbies, your social well-being, and all of those kind of things, right? So your health is more than just what's on your plate, and with you spending a lot more time at home, it's important that you create an environment that helps your health instead of hindering your health, okay? So without further ado, let's get into the five simple steps that you can do to improve the health of your home and which in essence will improve the health of you, okay? So let's get into it. So number one, the first way that you can improve your health is, this was my like least favorite chore growing up, sorry mom. But if I knew what I know now, then I definitely would not have skipped out on this chore. And it's just dusting regularly, okay? And I know that may sound mundane, but it really is an important piece of creating a healthier home environment. Why? Well, because our dust is a collection of particles, and particles could be our dead skin cells, it could be from cleaning products, it could be from the synthetic fabrics and fibers on the furniture. At the end of the day, the dust is a collection of all those particles. And if we're not removing those particles, then we're constantly breathing in and inhaling those harmful chemicals, okay? So we definitely wanna make sure that we are dusting regularly to eliminate the harmful chemicals that we're inhaling on a daily basis, okay? And it's really important that you dust with a wet cloth instead of a dry cloth, because when you're dusting with the dry cloth, then that's gonna put all the particles back into the air and you're gonna be inhaling them again. So it's important to absorb it with the wet cloth instead, so you're not creating any agitation or anything like that, okay? So the first way to do it is dust regularly, because these chemicals that are collected in those particles have been linked to hormone, you know, disruption, fertility issues and stuff like that. And I'm gonna get into a little bit more of that in just a second with the number two way, okay? So dusting, sorry mom, I didn't really do that when I was supposed to when I was home, so. But dusting is super, super important, so make sure you dust regularly, okay? All right, the second way, okay, for you to create a healthier home environment is to become a mindful consumer, okay? I know you're probably thinking like, well, what's the correlation with that? Well, if we go back to what I just said about dusting and about the dust being collection or accumulation of the particles from what we bring into our house, if you're becoming a mindful shopper and consumer and you are being more considerate of what you're bringing into your home, then the dust particles are not gonna be as harmful to us that we're gonna be inhaling, right? So the plastics that we bring into our homes, the carpets and the furnitures that we purchase. It really is important that we are consuming and purchasing items that are not filled with harmful chemicals like plastic, like the bisphenol A, and then also your PVC, right? So those plastics are harmful. They're known to cause behavioral changes in children. And these are all found in the linings of your shower curtains. Also, it's also part of our food packaging, right? So the food packaging that we're bringing into our home with the plastics, and these have all been linked, like I said, to cancer, to behavioral changes, and even hormonal disruption, right? So it's being a mindful consumer, and when you're purchasing even your furniture, trying for organic or more natural fibers, which are really important because, again, some of the clothing that we wear can release chemicals into our skin, and our skin can absorb it. So it's important that we are becoming more mindful shoppers in that regard. And the way to do that is buying glass containers when possible, or using glass containers when possible, choosing BPA-free and PVC-free, you know, plastics. Nowadays, more people are doing that, so that's really important. And then also making your own cleaning products. I created or posted a blog about that last week, or I think it was in my newsletter, actually. So if you're not subscribed to my newsletter, make sure you do that, where I provided you your cleaning solution so you're not inhaling all of those harmful chemicals in the cleaning products as well, okay? So again, the dust is a collection of those particles that we are bringing into our home. So one way to eliminate that is to be more a mindful consumer. And I know we can't really avoid all, you know, toxins. I get that, I understand that. It's just to be a more mindful consumer in what you're bringing into your home and in essence into your body, okay? So that's the number two, be a more mindful consumer, okay? Number three, I'm so excited about this one because, yeah, this is like plants are finally getting their just due shine, right? So add some life into your life, okay? Number three is adding some life into your life by adding plants. Got my plant back here. I'm a proud parent of 12 plants. Trying to see if I want to add in more, you know, I don't know. So I'm a proud plant parent of 12, and I love having plants in my home. Not only are they beautiful, but they also add a lot of benefits, okay? So let's get into that now. So they really do help with our mind, body, and spirit. So they have a calming essence to it. And they actually have done research on this and how people respond in office surroundings and settings when there are plants in an office and when there's not, or when there's windows in an office and when there's not. The people who have plants in their office have been more productive and more attentive and more have a more calming effect to them and a lower blood pressure actually as well, instead of those who didn't have the calming essence of plants in their office surrounding. Okay, so not only are plants just beautiful to have into your home and just welcoming and inviting, they also lower your blood pressure, help you reduce stress, improve your moods. They actually limit the collection of dust in your home. So back to the dust, right? And then they remove toxins. They actually neutralize the air that we breathe. So these suckers are amazing. And so it's really good to have some plants in your home to not only make it warming and inviting, but they also have a plethora of health benefits as well, okay? So here are a few that you can actually, and a lot of people I'm pretty sure have heard of these, the spider plant, the snake plant, and then the aloe vera, okay? So those are a few that you can get into if you don't have any house plants as of yet. I have the spider and the snake plant. I love, my spider has populated and it's so big. And so I'm waiting on an aloe plant. I have a friend that's gonna be giving me an aloe plant soon. So that'll be one that'll actually make 13 of my babies, my plant babies. So add some life into your life, bringing some plants into your home. But here's the kicker. They have to be real plants, y'all, okay? So sorry for my fake plant lovers. No fake plants allowed, because you can't reap the benefits from those, okay? So to reap the benefits, you need real plants. I get it, fake plants can still give you the calming effect, but you're not gonna get the real mental and eternal benefits that you would by having the real life greenery and foliage in your home, okay? So no fake plants allowed, all right? So, and really the three that I just recommend, you don't need a green thumb. So there's no need to have a green thumb when you have these live plants in your home. Literally just watering them once a week, you'll be fine, okay? All right, so moving on to the fourth. So the number fourth way to create space, a healthier home environment, is to create a wellness space, all right? So with so many people being home more, it's been hard to get to the gym, especially with what's been going on. If you don't live in a building that has a gym or a complex that has a gym, then you've had to create some wellness spaces at home. And it really is important to do this because we all need our own little nook, you know, of space that creates this calm and this peace for us, that's away from the television, it's away from just everything else, and it's your designated space for wellness, okay? So you could have a meditation corner in your home, right? Fill it with candles, books and journals, some incense and stuff like that. Your kitchen counters, so like if you're living with someone, one space could be, you know, dedicated to you for your superfoods and your herbal teas and stuff like that. And then also the workout space. Oh yeah, your yoga mats, any stretching, you know, bands that you may have or want or need, those can be included in there. Or just a small nook or a cushion next to a table, just a designated space for wellness that you can go to meditate, just decompress and relax, okay? That is really important to have a wellness space, a designated space for you to go to create some calmness and balance and center into your life, okay? So that's the fourth way. All right. And last but not least, the fifth and final way to create a healthier home environment is to set your kitchen up for success. Okay. Now, what this means is if you don't buy it, you don't eat it. All right. So this includes your pantry. Okay. So if your pantry is full of highly processed foods, that has a long list of ingredients that you can't pronounce, it's time for a kitchen overhaul, okay? So if you don't buy it, you don't eat it. If you're bringing in the bad, harmful foods, I won't say bad, but the lower quality foods, right, that are not helping your health, they're hindering it, then we gotta do a pantry overhaul, okay? So go through your pantry and, you know, look at the back of your food labels. If it's a long list of ingredients that you can't pronounce and you don't know what it is, then you probably shouldn't be eating it, okay? And the shorter the list, the less processed it is, and which means less chemicals, okay? So again, back to the chemicals from being a mindful consumer. It's looking back at those labels and seeing what you're bringing into your home, because you're bringing it into your body as well, okay? So set your kitchen up for success. Go through your pantry and see what you need to kick out. If it's loaded with additives, preservatives, and chemicals, it's gotta go, okay? So that is your five simple ways to create a healthier home environment. And then here's a couple of more. So get an air purifier if you live in the city, all right? So that's really important. Share your intentions with other people that are in your space, right? So like I said, if you share your space with someone else, let them know, hey babe, or hey whoever, this is the designated wellness space, perfect. Clean up after your pets if you have them, because you know, pet, you know, stuff, they actually have a lot of harmful chemicals and we don't want to be consuming those as well. And then open your windows, lift up your blinds and your shades, open your windows, let some fresh air in, some sunlight in, that will get some good air circulating and that you'll be inhaling and all those good things, all right? So a healthy home is not just about cleaning, it's also about your kitchen as well. So those are your five ways to create a healthy home environment. I want you to dust regularly to get those chemicals out of the way, those particles. I want you to become a mindful shopper and consumer about what you're bringing into your home. Add some life by adding some plants. Create your own wellness space, and then also set your kitchen up for success and do a pantry overhaul, all right? So I hope you found this helpful. Don't forget to grab a free copy of my food and pantry checklist, which will help you actually create a nutritious and delicious meal for those times when you don't have to, you know, time to get to the grocery store. Your pantry will be well stocked and ready to go, okay? So get that free copy in the description below, and that's it. Thank you for watching today's episode. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you now can know how to make and create a healthier home environment for you and your family. And yeah, don't forget to like and subscribe, and I will see you guys next Friday for next episode. See you then. Bye.